In other news, the annual Feast Day of the Dead in the Philippines is marked by the families of suspects killed during the Duterte drug war. They deplored the injustice suffered by the victims and the admission of ex-President Duterte that he had a death squad to kill drug suspects. Vivian Guler reports.
Joralyn Fuelias could not hold back her tears as she visited her husband's remains at the Dambana ng Paghilom in La Loma Cemetery in Caloocan City on the eve of All Saints Day. It has been over 7 years since he was shot dead by riding in tandem assailants in Manila on her birthday. But Fuelias says justice remains elusive.
Naiiyak ako kasi hindi pa siya nabibigyan ng katarungan eh. Walang gustong mag-witness.
She and other relatives of drug war victims are pinning their hopes of getting justice on the International Criminal Court's investigation into Duterte's drug war for alleged crimes against humanity.
Kasi dito parang ano eh, niluluto. Parang ano, parang may kinakampiyan sila, parang may pinapaboran. Kaya parang ang hirap makamtan yung justisya rin dito.
Ang mga kalaban natin ay nasa mayayaman, ma-impluensya. Alam naman natin na dito sa Pilipinas, makulong lang sandali, pagka-alyado ang nakaupo, nakakalabas din sila. Kaya hirap talaga kamitin ang hustisya dito sa Pilipinas. Kung kailan ako tumanda, 60 na ako, doon ako natutong sumama sa rally para ipaglaban ng katarungan para sa kanya. Tapos may sasalubong sa akin ng mga DDS na kami mga bayaran.
A ceremony for their departed loved ones was held at the Dambana ng Paghilom on Thursday, while Father Flavi Villanueva offered words of comfort to the families. More than 40 urns are currently in the memorial site for victims of alleged extrajudicial killings.
Isinisimbolo na kaya bilog ito, hindi kayo nag-iisa. Yakap at patuloy tayo magyakapan para makamtan natin yung paghilom dahil malalim ang sugat na idinulot ni Duterte at ang mga taong inutusan niyang pumatay. Sa usaping paghilom, hindi maalis ang katarungan.
In an interview with ABS-CBN News, Villanueva and Cuartero disputed claims that former President Rodrigo Duterte's statements during the Senate probe last Monday were mere jokes. Duterte had talked at length about instructing police officers to go drug suspects into fighting back to justify killing them, and said the chiefs of police were part of the Davao death squads.
There could be no joke when you're under oath. Walang panahon ng pagbibiro kapag ang usapin ay katotohanan at patungkol sa buhay na pinaslang. Kung talaga nanlaban, anong ebidensya? Gusto kong makita yung 6,000 baril na ginamit ng 6,000 nanlaban with their corresponding case reports.
Joke lang ba yun? May namatay, joke lang. Nanlaban, tinaniman nila yung anak ko ng baril. Joke lang ba yun? Totoo yung mga pinagsasabi niya, walang joke po doon. Hindi po, under oath po siya eh.
House Committee and Human Rights Chairperson Bienvenido Abante Jr. urged the public to remember the victims of extrajudicial killings, saying the masterminds of the brutal war on drugs have yet to be held accountable. He urges the Supreme Court to recommend to Congress the enactment of laws that will set fair and reasonable deadlines on criminal cases to uphold the right of victims to speedy justice. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
Military and civilian law enforcers raid a suspected offshore gaming hub in the Philippine province of Bataan. It is the latest in an ongoing crackdown on pogos that have been banned nationwide by President Marcos. The company Central One is suspected to be a front for illegal offshore gaming, but its CEO insists the company is a business process outsourcing firm.
Nakita tayo ngayon na meron silang offshore gaming operations talaga. Actual, tumatanggap sila ng mga pataya. So dito sa operations nila, nagpapataya sila, doon pumapasok para chikas mechanism yung pataya.
Okay.
So wala na. Meron na tayong enough basis para ipasara ito at kasuhan natin itong mga to, mapapilipino or foreigners for operating an offshore gaming operations without the necessary permit.
The suspended chief of the Philippine Energy Regulatory Commission is reinstated to her post. The ombudsman cut short the six-month suspension of Mona Lisa de Malanta, which was supposed to end in January next year. The commission says the ombudsman review of the case found that the grounds for de Malanta suspension no longer exist. It gave no further details. De Malanta suspension stemmed from a complaint by the consumer rights group that is called NASCOR. She was accused of illegally allowing power distributor Meralco to charge consumers for more expensive energy bought from the wholesale electricity spot market. Households in a storm-affected areas of the Philippines get a reprieve from paying their electric bills. The Energy Regulatory Commission instructed electric cooperatives and distribution utilities to hold off from disconnecting consumers who cannot pay their October to December bills. The commission's order applies to areas under a state of calamity in the wake of severe tropical storm Christine. The moratorium covers consumers whose monthly power consumption does not exceed 200 kilowatt hours. President Marcos downgrades the anniversary of his father's downfall to a special working holiday next year. The People Power Revolution of 1986 had previously been observed as a special non-working holiday. The anniversary, marked on the 25th of February each year, commemorates the civilian-backed military revolt that ended the dictatorial rule of former President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. Meanwhile, the third largest Philippine religious group is given its own special non-working holiday. Marcos declared the 27th of July next year as a holiday marking the founding anniversary of the Iglesia Ni Cristo.